The places that people choose to relax and be comfortable in are often closely associated with natural beauty. Woods, forests, seacoasts, and riverbanks. With their clean air and open spaces, and often near water, these give people a sense of well-being and happiness. One of the reasons why we human beings look for natural beauty is because God has created us to take pleasure in the beauties of paradise. Whether a person is aware of it or not, he is waiting for the blessings of paradise. God describes paradise to us in the Quran with all the attributes of nature. But those who have faith and do right actions will have gardens with rivers flowing under them. That is the great victory. In several hadith, our Prophet describes the trees of paradise. In paradise, there is a tree under whose shade a river could travel for 100 years without covering the distance completely. The trunk of every tree in paradise is of gold. Many hadith describing the beauties of paradise speak of the tree called Tuba and of its characteristics. Our Prophet's descriptions of the tree are as follows. Tuba is a tree in paradise, which spreads out as much as a distance that can be covered in 100 years. Robes for the dwellers of paradise will sprout from its buds. Tuba has matchless features and is very broad. In addition, the hadith say that in paradise, where the natural causes of this world no longer apply, clothes are also made out of this tree. Rivers are another of the natural beauties of paradise. The Prophet made frequent mention of the rivers in paradise. The rivers of paradise spring from mountains or hills of musk. In paradise there is a sea of honey, a sea of wine, a sea of milk, and a sea of water, and the rivers flow out of these seas. These rivers are described in detail in the Quran. An image of the garden which is promised to those who guard against evil. In it there are rivers of water which will never spoil, and rivers of milk whose taste will never change, and rivers of wine, delightful to all who drink it, and rivers of honey of undiluted purity. In it they will have fruit of every kind and forgiveness from their Lord. Is that like those who will be in the fire timelessly, forever, with boiling water to drink, which lacerates their bowels? In the hadith and verse, honey, milk, and wine are given as an example. But the milk, honey, and wine referred to here have been created with very different characteristics, unique to paradise, to those in this world. Each one in paradise is an immaculate, delicious, and restorative drink. The wine in paradise, for instance, bears no resemblance to that in this world. The people of paradise will not get headaches from them or lose their self-composure. In another verse of the Quran, God reveals, white as driven snow, delicious to those who drink, which has no headache in it and does not leave them stupefied.